Shall we stand and come together?
Amen.
And turn off that. Thank you. The music. How are you this morning? I see beautiful smiles. Wow. Early in the morning. It's beautiful outside. We have so much to be thankful for. You know, it's better to be here than in the best hospital in town. I'd rather be here. As soon as our music, our words come up,
they're not going to be there.
Oh, it's not going to come up.
Not on that
one. Okay, let's sing. Let us come, let us worship the Lord all together here today. Let us worship the Lord in His presence as we pray. He'll be there to receive you and His presence you'll enjoy. Be at peace with the Lord today. I am at peace with my Maker since He brought me here today. I'm at peace with the Lord who has washed my sins away. I'm at peace with my Savior, for He filled my heart with joy. I'm at peace with the Lord today.
One more time as people are coming in.
Come, let us worship the Lord together here today. Let us worship the Lord in His presence as we pray. He'll be there to receive you and His presence you'll enjoy. Be at peace with the Lord today. I am at peace with my Maker since He brought me here today. I'm at peace with the Lord who has washed my sins away.
I'm at peace with my Savior,
for He filled my heart with joy.
I'm at peace with the Lord today. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. You guys sounded good. That was beautiful to come into. Hallelujah. And let's sing. Oh, this is the day. This is the day that the Lord has made. That the Lord has made. I will rejoice. I will rejoice and be glad in me. And be glad in me. This is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. This is the day, this is the day that the Lord has made. Oh, what a mighty God He serves. What a mighty God He serves. Angels bow before Him, heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God we serve. There's plenty in the rock, there's plenty in the rock. Whoa, it tastes like honey in the rock. Taste and see. The Lord is good. It tastes like honey in the rock. Oh, what a mighty God we serve. What a mighty God we serve. Angels are before Him. Heaven and earth adore Him. What a mighty God we serve. I'm gonna march all around that city where my loved ones have gone on before. I'm gonna sit on the banks of the river where we'll meet the part no more. There's honey in the rock. There's honey in the rock. Oh, it tastes like honey in the rock. Oh, taste and see. The Lord is good. It tastes like honey in the rock.
Give the Lord praise. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We love you, Lord. We give it
glory, Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Just welcome him into the house today. We welcome you, Lord. We give you glory, Lord. We give you honor, Lord. You are worthy of all praise. Hallelujah. Worthy, 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 worthy is the Lamb of God who was slain from the foundation of the world. You're worthy, Lord. Oh, we welcome you, Holy Spirit, into this house today. We give you glory and honor and praise and thanksgiving, Lord. We come into your presence with singing, Lord. We come into your porch with praise, Lord. We come into your porch with thanksgiving, O Lord. You're a mighty God who loves us so much. You've done so much for us. You lifted us up, Lord, when we were down. You took us out of the fiery pit, and you put us on the sure foundation, the rock, Christ Jesus. Oh, you lay in Zion a cornerstone. Hallelujah. A sure stone. A tried stone. Hallelujah. The precious rock. Rock of ages. Jesus Christ. The rock of all salvation. Oh, on Christ alone. On Christ alone we stand. On Christ alone. Hallelujah. Oh, Lord, we love you so much today. We give you glory here today. We invite your Holy Spirit to move and operate and to do your good pleasure in this assembly today, Lord. Lord, we're not here for us, Lord. We're not here to get a good praise on. We're not here for us to get the Holy Ghost goosebumps, Lord. Oh, we like the blessing of your presence. Lord, we're here to worship you, Lord. Your words and the word, those who worship you must worship you in spirit and in truth. So we come to worship you, Lord. Oh, Lord, we're not going to wait to ask, Lord, and to any that don't know you today, because today is the day of salvation. Right now, if there's anyone in the house that doesn't know Christ Jesus, you can come to this altar and you can get invited into your heart as your Lord and Savior. You can do it right there in your chair too. Lord, we thank you, Lord, for the blood of Jesus. We thank you, Lord, that you saved us, oh God. Lord, we ask you to forgive us of our sins, Lord. We ask you to cleanse us with the blood of Jesus. We confess with our mouth that Jesus, Yeshua, is the Messiah. He is the Messiah. As he went, died on Calvary's Hill, and on the third day, God, your Spirit raised him from the dead, and he's now at the right hand of the Father, making intercession for us. We accept you, Lord Jesus. We ask you to wash away our sins. Let us come boldly into the throne of the grace, entering by the blood of the Lamb, that we might worship you, Lord, and we can worship you in spirit, and we can worship you in truth, and we can lift up your holy name, for there is none of us unto you, O God. We give you praise and glory and honor and thanksgiving. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Have your way today, Lord. Have your way today, Lord. We bow before your throne. We bow. We want more of you, God. More of you, God. Less of us, more of you. Hallelujah. In Jesus' name we pray. And all the saints said, amen and amen. You know, we don't always have to wait till the end of the service to make sure we're right with the Lord. Amen. It's good to do it at the beginning of the service. Amen. Because the prayers of the unrighteous are an abomination to the Lord. And we want to worship him in spirit. And we want to worship him in truth. Give the Lord praise. Hallelujah. We love you, Jesus. Hallelujah. And Watts has a word for us today. I know that Ray has a special for us. Hallelujah. I know the Holy Spirit is going to move. You may be seated in his presence today. God is a good God. He's a good God, Sharon, isn't he? Amen. He's a good God, Ruth, huh? Amen. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, you are welcome in this place. Omnipotent Father, full of mercy and grace, thou art welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place. Holy Spirit, thou art welcome in this place. Omnipotent Father, full of mercy and grace, thou art welcome in this place. You may be seated. Hallelujah. You know, I wanted the children, I'm so glad to see the children in the house. I wanted the children to come up here and join me if they're not too embarrassed. You'll come up here. I want to sing a couple children's songs because we haven't had. Do you not want me to come back there instead? I'll come back. We'll come back here instead. Do you guys know Jesus Loves Me? Do you know that song? It goes like this.
Jesus loves me, this I know, for the Bible tells me so. Little ones to him belong, they are weak, but he is strong. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. Yes, Jesus loves me. The Bible tells me so.
How about Jesus loves the little children,
all the children of the world. Red, yellow, black, and white, they are precious in His sight. Jesus loves the little children of the world.
And how about this little light of mine?
I'm gonna let it shine. This little light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine.
Let it shine,
let it shine, let it shine. Hide it under a bushel.
No!
I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel.
No!
I'm gonna let it shine. Hide it under a bushel.
No!
I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
Won't that Satan get out?
I'm gonna let it shine.
Won't that Satan
get out? I'm gonna let it shine. Won't that Satan get out? I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Let it
shine. Shine all over the neighborhood.
I'm gonna let it shine.
Shine all over the neighborhood.
I'm gonna let it shine. Shine all over the neighborhood. I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine.
All right, amen. That sounded good. You know, I think we're all. The Word of God tells us that unless we can be like little children, we can't enter the kingdom of God. Amen. I think that's why we all get a blessing when we sing the songs we learned in Sunday school. Amen. I see a guest. Welcome. Good to have you with us this morning. Hallelujah. Good morning, Lord. Good to have you back. And looking. This isn't a guest, but this is someone I'm glad to see. I haven't seen you for a while. Thank you. What's that? Oh, where is Scott?
Yeah, that's me.
Floyd. That's his name. That's who I was about to read. Floyd, right?
Sorry, pretty traffic.
Your brother's not good to see you. That's all right. We're going to go. We're going to ask Sister Julie to come and to share the couple of announcements we have. Welcome.
Good morning.
Good morning.
You know there's no announcements in the bulletin, but guess what?
What?
I remember.
All right.
So I'm hoping everybody can go out I regret I won't be able to be there today because it's Greg's birthday today. So I'll be with him today. But praise God, I hope you guys all have a wonderful time and a good visit with everybody and think of it. Amen?
Amen.
Praise the Lord. Who loves the Lord this morning?
Amen.
Who loves the Lord?
Amen.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Praise God. You know what? I'm telling you something. I came from many years ago, I attended a church that was a few thousand people. You know, the choir was larger than our church. Okay? And that was beautiful. But you know what I like about the family of God is that He uses everything, you know? Everything. And He uses this little church. And when I say little, I mean maybe in size, but not in stature. In God's kingdom, amen? He does great things through this church. If you knew the blessings that flow out from this church, you would be amazed. And I'm amazed at what God does. Oh, He's so good. You know, there was a man named Gideon. You can read about him in the book of Judges. And he needed to go out to fight a war. And when he had thousands and thousands of men, I think 30,000 was his army. But God took his army and He whittled it down to just 300. And you know why He did that? He wanted to people to know it was God who gets the glory. Amen?
Amen?
It's always God. Amen? Hallelujah. It's always God. And God, little as much of He is in it. Amen? I want to turn your attention to the prayer requests on the back of the bulletin. We haven't read through them in just a while. How is Brother Cleo doing?
I
cannot
get a hold of
him. Oh, you can't get a hold of him? We're going to have to go by and see Brother Cleo this week. Oh, he's not home? Okay. You know where he went to? Okay, so let's keep Brother Cleo in prayer. Evangelist Cleo Thompson, let's pray for him and for, you know, his wife Dolores just passed away. Helen Berlin's family is still grieving. Crystal Shepherd suddenly lost her son, 33 years old. Those, her son Justin, and Lana lost her husband this year. Our friend Lana lost Rob. And we know they're with the Lord. But for those that remain, it's hard. You know, my father went home to be at the work. It'll be 12 years tomorrow. And, you know, it's hard. I still miss him every day. You know, sometimes when I'm praying, I'm not, there's nothing in the Bible about this, but a lot of times, except for that there's a cloud of witnesses, you know. And a lot of times when I'm praying, I'll say, now Lord, tell my daddy I miss him. You know, because I know where he's at, but I miss him, you know. As soon as I pray for our friends that have lost their loved ones, let's pray for Steve Emerson. He is an investigative journalist. He also does a lot of work that I'm not willing to talk about. But he's been keeping us all safe for many years. He's helped our government keep terrorists from infiltrating our borders. And he is recovering from C. diff. And that's a disease that when they give you too many antibiotics, your system does not fight them off. You know, anything. Anyway, his body started turned against itself, and he almost died. And the FBI actually did an investigation to see if he had been poisoned. And so, but anyway, just pray for Stephen Emerson. He's recovering. He thanked our church for our prayers. He said he really had given up all hope of living. And he said once we started praying, he said God has touched his body, and he's been restored. He's almost well enough to go back to the office, he said. Barbara Curley, let's pray for Barbara Curley. She has kidney stones. And let's continue to pray for Levi. Good things are happening with Levi, and let's pray that he'll be back in the congregation as her grandson. My son Jacob is almost home from North Dakota. He's driving today. When I spoke to him this morning, he was already in Reno. So he's all coming down that mountain. So pray for my son Jacob. You know, I need your prayers. I need your prayers every day. And so I said, pray for Pastor Hinkle, for guidance and strength, renewed health and wisdom. I need to shepherd this church, you know, and I went in. I thought I was going to get some relief from the doctors for the sinus thing that I've had for 15 years. And they have the most ridiculous recommendations. I'm not even going to repeat them. So I said, well, it's back to Dr. Jesus. Amen. So he's going to touch me and heal me. I know he is. Pray for our missionaries, our schools in Peru. We still don't know exactly what we're doing when we get there. God has delayed our plans. We were going to go this summer, and things got caught up, and we didn't go this summer. But God knows when we're supposed to be back, you know? So we want to do some things with our schools in Peru. Pray for Pastor John and Ariel and the 36 orphans of the orphanage that we sponsor. When I spoke to them last month, the week before last week, they said they were praising God that they were able to feed their children every other day. Every other day, one meal every other day. I was just in my personal ties to them because I haven't talked to them at the church. And we have other needs at the church we need to pay off. But when I said I was going to send my personal ties, they were rejoicing. They said, well, we're not going to tell the children until we get it on this end, because so many ministries promised to send money for food, and they never did. And so it's only $432 a month for those children to have food every single day. And so one way or another, in the future, we're going to be able to make sure that those kids are eating every day. You have to feed your kids every day, at least once a day. They are grateful to get to eat every other day. They said their averages used to be once every 4 days they got to feed the children. And so, one meal, yeah. So let's pray for them. They're precious, precious people. You can watch their crusades. Many people are coming to know the Lord. Not only do they have an orphanage, but they're going out and they're putting their life on the line in a predominantly Muslim area, and Muslim and other false religions, and they are preaching Jesus Christ. A blind man received the sight last week. Man was raised up out of crippled. They've been crippled since childhood. Got up and walked in their service. I mean, you can watch it right on Facebook. They're out spreading the gospel, taking care of the children, and I'm praying for them. Not only that you feed the children, but that God will give them long life, because they said the average life expectancy is only 40. And they were asking us to pray that God would send somebody to take over their work, because they're getting close to 40 and they expect to die or be killed. And, you know, it's a whole different world. We are so blessed here in the United States. You know? So let's pray for them. I'm praying that if it's all possible, that you'd be able to see Jesus coming in his glory. Amen. Hallelujah. That you would live to see him come. And then if it's a long ways off, to live to a ripe old age. Amen. And if it's soon, then praise the Lord. We'll go up together. So pray for them. Pray for Israel to grant Jews who are believers in Jesus the right of return. And that's really big on my heart, you know, that the Christians and Jews have been standing together in support of Israel and one another against radical Islam. But right now, if you're a Jewish person, you can go back to Israel unless you're a Christian. You know, you don't have the right to return, and that's a big deal. And so if you believe in Christ as the Jewish Messiah, you should still be able to go back to Israel and make it your homeland. Amen? Amen? So let's pray for the Knesset to change that law in their high courts. Terry and Kenneth are going to be here on the 18th. They left a beautiful work in Mexico after being on the mission field for 50 years. And so we would take them up in prayer. We still support Don Maggard, who is dear friends with the Young family. I met him one time before God called him up.
he has left to work in Mexico. We also support the work in India. We want to pray for them. Amen? Pray for the church, financial matters. Pray for the homeless here in Sacramento. Pray for all of the unsaved loved ones, that they will yield to the drawing of the Holy Spirit. Amen. My Aunt Lydia was in the hospital this morning, but God has already touched her. She's on her way home. Continue to pray that she can breathe. She has a breathing problem. And then let's agree right now in the name of Jesus. Hallelujah. Let's take authority at the beginning of this service right now over these evil spirits that try to come into every church. Amen. We just take authority over, let's do it together. We take authority over manipulation, sabotage, control, retaliation, confusion, conspiracy, division, and prejudice. Those have no business in the church of Jesus Christ. Amen? Hallelujah, hallelujah. We say the Lord rebuke you. Hallelujah. And go out of here. You have no authority here in none of these temples, because we are all sanctified and holy as unto the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. Are you ready to worship the Lord? Hallelujah. Yes, Grandma. Yes. She would like you to pray for me, but just stretch out your hands. That would be good. Praise God. Amen. I'll receive that. Pastor Fonda, why don't you lead in the prayer for me?
Father, gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you, Lord Jesus, that you took the stripes for our healing. Father, we trust you above all. Father, we ask you to touch Timothy's mind, God. These sinus cavities, Lord, that they be completely healed. Lord, we curse the infection in Jesus' name. And we ask you, Lord Jesus, to restore complete health to his body. Father, we just know, God, that you are setting everything up. Father, that you are a God of restoration. You are a God of healing and health. And we thank you this morning, Lord, for your promises are yea, amen, in the name of your God, Jesus, Lord. And we're righteous in you because of what you did for us. And we thank you in Jesus' precious name.
Amen. I thank you for the previous Brother Watts.
She's at the red light getting off the freeway and the car sideswiped the truck. And I thank the Lord she wasn't injured, but it did damage the truck real bad. And I thank the Lord because, you know, the Lord always have a ram in the bush. Now, the truck is used to go up the schoolhouse to get fruits and vegetables. It's used to, you know, use it for bread a little bit. But I thank the Lord for Junior and Angela and their family, because I called them at the last minute. They had a Suburban. They said, Mother, we're coming, get bread, we're coming, help. And I thank the Lord for them and their family. Praise God. And coming to help. But another thing I want to tell you, there's so many hungry people here in Sacramento. But also, our mission has gone to Stockton, California. We met a wonderful young man at the center during the summer. He's a pastor of a small church in Stockton, California. And he works at Twin River School District. And he said, Mother, do you have any extra bread? And I said, yes. We're now feeding over 3,000 loaves of bread a month. We're going to Stockton where they're feeding over 600 people. They come, they live here in Sacramento, and one of the deacons live in Elk Grove. They come and pick up the food and the bread. They're feeding over 600 people a week. We're talking about a week. So this little church is doing big things for you. But with the help of the volunteers that I have, because all I can do is talk on the phone and talk, and I can't lift nothing anymore. But I thank the Lord for being able to feed the people. I thank the Lord, the homeless, they come, praise God. They get moved around every other week or every month. We don't know where they are, but they find us, praise God. And I thank the Lord for that. I thank the Lord for the pastor allowing us to to be free about doing some of the things I haven't been able to catch in or tell it because we've been so busy. But now we're doing over 3,000 loaves of bread a month. And that's not counting all the food and stuff we come in. We have also another church that call us, and we call them, we swap. If they have too much of some, Mary, come and get it. If I have too much, come and get it. And they've been letting us use their vehicle to go up to the schoolhouse to get food. And all they ask is quick gas in it. And I thank the Lord for the pastor, and I thank that church, and I thank the Lord for Bernice, who calls and we're very, very close together. I thank the Lord for my husband, and I thank the Lord for my helper Edward, because I call and everybody's right there. I call Junior and Andrew Leonard right there. I said, look, you come in, we got an abundance of things coming, we have to get it out. They're right there. I give them 5 minutes notice and they come. And I thank the Lord for that because that truly shows you that the mission work is of the Lord and still going on. It's not about us, it's not about TLC Soup Kitchen, about meeting the needs of the people. And the need is getting out there greater. I don't know if you ever, I'm from the country, I don't know if you ever noticed the weather. Versus getting dark early now. Yes. And all this cool weather we also have. And I've been telling them, I've been telling Bobby Jones, I said, I don't know, you better start storing up. I don't know if we're a rough winter or what, but you better start storing up. And the Lord has been preparing things to store up. All you have to do is watch the season. Watch, quit getting into self so much and watch what the Lord is trying to tell you. And watch the weather out there. My God, if you watch that weather out there, I mean, all you have to do is watch and listen to the Lord. And I thank the Lord for the teaching here because without the teaching, you're going to perish. You're going to perish because the Lord has been talking to us. He's been telling us. And it's not about self. You know, I told Lisa, I said, well, Lisa, I'm not worried about the truck. The freezer came out. I said, they totaled out. Let me just get another one. Our freezer went out. When the freezer went out, I said, I'm not worried about it. How come they say, look, a truck went down the street, the freezer's on there. I called the number. We got three of them. Because I heard two noise out there with the babies. But I said, and I called them, and I said, you know what, our freezer went out. Okay, I'm going to ask the pastor, and I'll see. He said, we have three of them, so they're going to call me this week, and he'll give me the freezer for you guys. And, you know, I thank the Lord for the refrigeration freezer we have here, because, well, I'm telling you, things are going to get rough. But to let you know how many people we are feeding, we're feeding so many people. And they keep coming, and keep coming. And I thank the Lord for working with Union Baptist. They called with abundance yesterday. And everybody, wait, I don't have to leave that house. They call, and if we pick up or they deliver. Now look how good God is. Amen. I mean, tons of food. I talk about a little bit, I mean tons of food.
Yes.
And I thank the Lord for that, providing for all of us, my volunteers. And we have more things to come. I have cooks already. We're already up until June of next year. That's how good God has been to us. I have to get everything down on paper,
find the pastor,
and let him know what's going on, and let him know how things are going. But we have cooks lined up, we have chefs lined up. I mean, everything is done. We have volunteers lined up, we have t-shirts lined up. Everything is done. And that's how God, you know, God's in the plan. And I thank the Lord for Sister B. And if you don't know who Sister B is, she's sitting right up there in the little green outfit next to my husband. That's Sister B. I call Sister B. Sister B, we need this here. And guess what's happening now? And Sister B, he doesn't. But I thank the Lord for her because God is truly being good. I can't thank the Lord enough. But he's taught me how to pray and not to worry my pastor. Even though I let him go on, but you know, Pat has a lot on his shoulder.
Yes.
And you know, we're here, the Lord didn't put us here for us to be leeches all our lives. He teaches us how to pray, how to lay hands on ourselves and pray, praise God. And our pastor is overburdened. Pastor, my cat died, Pastor, the dog is screaming in the yard. That's unnecessary. You could lay hands on yourself. You don't call that, Pastor, I'm sick today. Well, for crying out loud. I mean, how many days we don't feel good? Put your hand, lay your hands on yourself and pray. The Lord gave us authority. How are you going to have authority over the devil? You can't even pray for yourself. You can't do it. That's why we need to go for ourselves and know how to pray for ourselves and talk to each other, not to burn our pastor down. I want to stay around a little longer because he has a lot of flyers to do for me, so he has to stay around a little bit longer. So I can't have him bother right now. Praise God. But I thank the Lord for that, and I thank the Lord. Graphic's already done. I mean, everything is done. If you just know how good, if I can help me head for our good God is doing. I got a great grandbaby in the hospital. I hope to make peace in the day, but she'll be out probably by Tuesday. And that's Tink. She had a immune deficiency years ago. She ended up at Stanford University and had this thyroid, not thyroid, but a gland removed. And they, she's contacted. There's infection going around that the antibiotics don't even touch anymore. And so she had to go in the hospital and get her infusion again for 5 days. And I thank the Lord for the people and nurses at Sutter Hospital. Oh my God, I love them. I love them there. Praise God. But you know, I thank the Lord for each and every, not only them, but each and every one of you all who have been an example to me and have the mothers been here. And I've been telling Grandma Mary what an example she was to me. I said, I remember the old time after he would put us up in camp. I'll never forget those camp days. Hallelujah. How the Lord just came down and spoke, and I was praying and stuff. And how I always go to the kitchen, Mother, what we have for breakfast, what we have for lunch. I was interested in the food because Mother cooked so good. And all the people, you know, there's some of them are gone now, Norma, and all the rest of them are cooking those good meals for us at the camp. And those are days where the Lord gave us memories. He gave us memories to know to thank Him and continue to thank Him. I thank Him every day for what He has done for me and how He has blessed me and kept my family and how the pastor blessed us. Where our home next door. Now, it's a revolving door every day, but that's the way it's supposed to be. Praise God. With the babies in heaven. But I just thank the Lord for each and every one of you, and as you continually pray, every family, for every family in this church, pray for Bobby Joe and Edward, and also pray for all those that are not here. I love you guys so much. We have a lot to do. So if you don't see me or hear me, I am busy. But you can call or come by anytime. The door's always open. I think I earned $1 million once that door opened this year. But anyway, come by anytime. I love you guys. God bless you.
Hallelujah.
I don't know, do they get the vacuuming and the sanctuary taken care of?
Do we have
the sign-up sheet?
The sign-up sheet?
Yes.
Okay, so this week we need somebody to vacuum the sanctuary on Saturday. Is that right, Pastor?
Mm-hmm. Yes,
okay.
Ma'am.
Okay, we all stepped up this week.
All right, praise God.
Okay, so.
Hallelujah, thank you, Jesus.
Okay.
Thank you very much, Julie. This is real. Let's do our testimonies right now. Because then we'll go, no, we have all God's plan sometimes is different than ours.
I know last week I thanked the Lord for everybody here, but I want to thank you. Our roof is real bad. And I asked the Lord to make a way for this roof. And my house. And I would say, Lord, you know the needs. I never asked him again about the roof, but I did tell him, Lord, you know the needs. Well, my husband's brother gave him a boat. The engine needs some work on it. It's a nice boat you can take out on the river. Well, the Lord blessed us and sent a friend of the family's, and he said, I will roof your house for that boat.
Oh, wow.
We have to buy the material. The roofers charge more to roof than what the roofing paper is. And I just want to thank him for it. Anybody who has a need, put it in God's hands and just tell him.
Yeah.
You know what needs to be done. It's in your hands. And I praise him for it.
Amen.
to test it. Brother Ray has a word for the Lord.
I was a firefighter in the city of Sacramento in this area partly for 30 years almost. And during those 30 years, I was living on a fire at one time. And I was driving a fire, I drove a fire engine after the burn for 5 weeks. I didn't know that I was burned that bad in the nasal passage. During that last time I drove the fire engine to the on the way to the fire, I was going blind. And I had to give the engine to my partner. I just barely got to the fire. And I went ahead and fought the fire, but I was fighting it in a blind mode. So I came back to the firehouse. And when I got back to the firehouse that day, I just happened to have a dental appointment that my wife was supposed to pick me up and take me to the dental appointment. When I got to the dental appointment, I got into the chair, I told the dentist, I said, you know, I can't smell and I can't taste, and my nose is plugged from one end to the other. I thought I had a cold, and I didn't. I had been burned in the nasal passage from the burn on the fire. Well, I'm telling you this because Timothy has one side of his nose is plugged like my whole brain was all the way. Mine was so bad that a staph infection gathered through the eggshell membrane between the brain and the nasal passage. And when the dentist said, I'm not going to treat you today, I want you to take him to the emergency. So they took me to the emergency and found that I had 6 days to live. And that's how fast the staph infection was growing. So I tell you this because the pastor's situation is more severe than he lets on. One side of his nose is plugged, and it's plugged all the time. When it's like that, you can't get rid of things in your nose and stuff and pass it, and infections gather. And this gave me 6 days to live. When they took me in, after they called me within 4 hours of the culture test, I was in 6 hours in surgery. And after 6 hours of surgery, I was 10 months off the work and I couldn't see the drive or nothing. Today, my wife does all the driving and that's when it started. I don't drive anymore too much when she's in the car because she took over the steering wheel after that because I couldn't drive. But I'm just saying that because it's a serious situation. I need to pray that these doctors will start doing something and get it taken care of because it's more serious than you think. So I just wanted to let you know what
you know it's such a good life. And you know what? God is so good. He is so good. And I sure appreciate Brother Ray. And I'm doing my part, I'm going to the doctor. But what they wanted to do was I believe an attack from the devil because the lady that the surgeon that was supposed to fix my sinuses, she also wanted me to take out my tonsils, my uvula, part of my tongue, and give me a hold of my neck and make me lose my voice. So I'd not be able to talk or sing or anything. And that was the devil. Yeah, that is not God's way. They said that's what the sleep apnea doctor recommended, was that they give me a hold of my neck so I could breathe. I refuse to accept that as God's highest and best. And I'm a preacher, and I'm not letting the devil take my voice. Amen? I'm going to sing, I'm going to preach for the Lord. But I do need to get, God needs to either touch this, or the doctors need to drain it or something. And they're not wanting to do that. They're wanting to do all these crazy operations. And so I'm a little bit concerned, a little bit confused with the bad retort that the doctors are giving, you know. So. But I remember this little song we used to sing called, Whose Report Are You Going to Believe? I'm going to believe the report of the Lord. Amen? And I believe in doctors, but I believe in Dr. Jesus, too, the great physician. So I do covet and appreciate your prayers. And God is so good. Amen.
Amen.
Let's worship Him today. I know our worship. Oh, look at this beautiful family that's donated. Yes. And you know, Brother Ronnie, he installed that for the church. So if you see him around, tell him. He said, thank you. Yeah, that's Sister Mary's son-in-law. He's doing some work at my house, too. Yeah. Praise God. Let's stand and go to the Lord.
As your people declare your life. With twain he did fly.
And one cried unto another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the posts of the door moved, and the voice of him that cried, and the house was filled with smoke. Then said I, Woe is me, for I am undone, because I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For mine eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then flew one of the seraphims unto me, having a live coal in his hand, which he had taken with the tongs off from off the altar. And he laid it upon my mouth, and he said, Lo, this has touched thy lips, and thy iniquity is taken away, and thy sin purged. And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then said I, Here am I, send me. And he said, Go and tell this people, Hear ye indeed, but understand not, and see ye indeed, but perceive not. Make the heart of this people fat, and make their ears heavy, and shut their eyes, lest they see with their eyes, and hear with their ears, and understand with their heart, and convert, and be healed. Then said I, Lord, how long? And he answered, Until the city be wasted without inhabitant, and the houses without men, and the land be utterly desolate, and the Lord have removed them far away, and there be a great forsaking in the midst of the land, that yet end shall be intent, and it shall return, and shall be eaten as of a tile tree, and as of an oak, whose substance is in them. When they cast their leaves, so the holy seed shall be substance thereof. Pastor, what's that have to do with anything? You see the seasons, they ebb and they flow. And that was prophesied of the time when Israel would be carried away captive. We know that happened. But it was also prophesied in several places, including Amos chapter 9, that God would rebuild the walls. Amen? It all starts with worship, though. We have to be in the house of the Lord and worshiping Him. And the walls of your life that have been desolate, they can be rebuilt in Christ Jesus. Amen? They can be rebuilt. He promises to come again and to restore the former things that the enemy had laid waste. Amen? Hallelujah. But when we go into the worship, our goal should be to get into the Holy of Holies. Amen? Hallelujah, 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 hallelujah. Praise you, Lord. Praise you, Lord. Hallelujah. 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 You know, the Lord is speaking to us right now. He's even speaking through the voice of a child. He's given us an illustration. He's had to be sensitive to what the Holy Spirit is doing to understand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Son of the Spirit, I'll give you a microphone now. want you to sing unto the Lord because he's pleased.
Spirit, fill our welcome here. down. He's trying to build their lives there, trying to get to the gospel, trying to blind their eyes, trying to steer them to the right spot. We know you're coming back soon. Father, I pray for these men and all that you put in their heart from a child until now. Establish in the name of Jesus. Establish in the name of Jesus.
Oh,
last night the Lord woke me up, and as we're singing this song, reminds me of what he was telling me. He woke me up at about 3-4 o'clock in the morning, and he said, I want you to put a plan together. See, using your talents, you already have. He said, I want you to put a marketing plan together to reach this neighborhood and to let them know that there's healing in the house of God. And I want you to have, declare a day of healing and have a healing service. And I said, Lord, who are you going to send with the anointing of healing? That's gonna, he said, everyone in the house can receive their healing. There will be blind eyes open, there will be people healed. See, as I'm speaking this, the devil's trying to steal it from me. He's trying to steal my faith. But you know what, I'm going to speak it anyway. He said, I'm going to heal. He says, I said, who are you going to use? He said, I'm going to use you, son. I'm going to use the body there, son. So I want you to start praying even now for a day of healing, a day of increase. And we're going to invite the neighborhood and the city to come and receive the healing God has for them. Amen? The Word of God says greater things. Greater things. Greater things. Greater things shall you do. He's going to use this vessel. He's going to use these vessels right here in these seats to pray for the sick and the lame. And we're going to see healing in our midst. Amen.
God died on the cross and rose again for our healing.
And I stand on his promise for our healing. For Pastor, you know, when the Lord laid it on Pastor's heart to have the service for healing, I believe the Lord's going to start it in him. He's going to start it from the top and filter it all the way down to all of us. I know this is offering time, but I just have such a hunger right now. He doesn't just want you. He wants everything. You know, we hold back so much. Like Sister Mary said, there's people out there that are hungry. It's got to start by sharing, giving, and the desire to love others. He wants to use us. You know, this country, I forget even what it is, they eat one meal a day or every other day. But in Pakistan, $41. You know, and we just hold back. You know, my husband gave me a scripture, and it's more of a story. And I think many of us can really relate. It's a single mom's grocery money. It's a story about a single mom with young children. Her ex-husband sent her only a small amount of grocery money every week. So small it couldn't even feed one person, much less her family of four. But she decided to begin giving to God from her little bit of grocery money and trust him to provide. Shortly after, she got a job with a cookbook company. The company paid her to go grocery shopping and prepare meals so that they could take photographs for their cookbooks. When they were done taking pictures, she could keep the food. They told her she could keep the food she had purchased and prepared. Isn't that an amazing story of God's goodness? Nancy learned that even if you're poor, you still need to give from whatever you have. You know, we're not poor. None of us. Even the poorest of poor here in this country are not poor. We have something to give. I don't care what it is. And you know, we have this roof over our head, and you know, we have commitments. And in order for us to help others, we have to start helping ourselves first with what we have, the obligations that we have. And in order for us to do that, it has to begin in us. Only in us. It can't start anywhere else. And we're going to help this community. You know, I went and picked up Lori this morning, and I saw so many people that we could be ministering to at the apartments where she's living. And you know, her daughter lives there, and she has three kids. And you know, there's many people that we could be missing and, you know, ministering to. And you know, it's only a couple miles from here. You know, the Lord wants to, I know I keep going on about, but the Lord wants us to help others. I can see a building. I can see us feeding people. Shelter. I can see that. But it has to begin in us. Today, we have to be willing to sacrifice, to give, to say, Lord, whatever it is you want from us, please show me. Begin it in me. I know you love the Lord, and I know you give, and I just want us to stretch. We need to stretch. He needs to stretch us in order to give us more. He wants us to have more. He wants us to have above and exceedingly above what we can imagine or think. But we can't just sit there and expect him just to give it to us. I'm sorry, I know I might seem like a little hard, but I'm not trying to be hard on you. I'm just trying to get through so that he can use us mightily and save. There's so, you know, I don't think that time is long before he comes. And we need to take it seriously. Yes.
Last Sunday, when we left here, I don't have pastor's permission to tell this, but he came back, when he got back in the car after getting gas, and he had tears in his eyes. And I looked at him and I said, what's going on? He said he was talking to a lady in the line in the gas station. She was hungry. And he didn't know it, but he had been talking to her about the Lord. And he asked her, do you know the Lord? She says, I like to think that I do, but her faith was waning because she had just told the Lord, I'm hungry, Lord, but I'll be happy with a piece of gum, and I will chew the gum, and I will be thankful. But he didn't know all this was going on in her brain. But the Lord led him to give her the change that he got back when he finished paying for his gas. And she began to weep, and she said, thank you, Lord, you do care. We are an instrument of the Holy Spirit, and when we're mindful of what he's calling us to do, he can turn the hearts and minds of people back to him. He can do a miracle in their life. I mean, that little gift wasn't much, but it was enough to cause this woman to start thanking God again and believing that he would be there, and he's a very present help in time of trouble.
Yes, he is.
We're a lighthouse. The Lord just gave me that. We're a lighthouse. We're going to go out and we're going to bless others. The Lord's going to bring people to us. Oh, let's stand. Hallelujah. It's exciting. It's exciting what the Lord is about to do. Thank you, Jesus. Oh, Lord, I just thank you for what you're doing in each and every one of us today. Lord, I just ask that you could complete your work in each and every one of us. Whether we have a dollar, whether we have 20, whether we have 100, whether we have 500, whether we have 1,000, whatever it is, God needs it. Excuse me, he doesn't need it. He wants it from us. He doesn't need anything. But we are his vessel, and he can speak through us. As we walk out the door, I ask that the light would just radiate within each and every one of us so that people can see you in us, Lord. Father, help our funds to multiply. Lord, help us to use it wisely. Help us to just be wise in our giving. Thank you, Jesus, for what you're about to do in each one of us. We thank you for our lives. We thank you for our jobs. We thank you for what you've given us. And we just ask that we would be able to reach others. And we just thank you, Holy Father, for everything. In Jesus' name, amen.
I want to ask Creator to worship you. I was created to worship you, for you are lovely and your ways are wonderful. I was created.
it's time to go into a depression now, and we like to share the roots of our faith. So if Kevin can put it up.
Pastor, is it on your computer?
Praise God. Isn't he a good God? Amen.
Yes.
Week of August 28th to September 3rd, 2016. The Torah, Deuteronomy 11, 26 to Deuteronomy 16, 17. The prophets, Isaiah 54, 11 to Isaiah 55, 5. Our gospel, John 16, 1 to John 17, 26. Giving to the poor. Thought for the week. You shall not hesitate to give nor murmur when you do give, because you shall know who is the good repayer of the hire. You shall not turn away from him that is in want, but you shall share all things with your brother, and shall not say that they are your own. For if you are partakers in that which is immortal, how much more in things which are mortal? Didache 4, 7 through 8. The commentary. You shall generously give to him, and your heart shall not be grieved when you give to him. Because for this thing the Lord your God will bless you in all your work and in all your undertakings. Deuteronomy 15, 10. The Torah commands us to give generously to the poor. You shall freely open your hand to your brother, to your needy, and poor in your land. Deuteronomy 15:11. The master taught frequently about giving to the poor and encouraged his followers to do so lavishly. Believers should be distinguished as the most generous people on earth. When Paul received permission from the apostles to take the gospel to the Gentiles, the apostle gave him only one stipulation. They asked him to teach the Gentiles to remember the poor. Genesis 2:10. When we give to the poor, we should do so with a glad heart. The Torah says, your heart shall not be grieved when you give to the poor man. Deuteronomy 15:10. That is why Paul says, each one must do just as he has purposed in his heart, not grudgingly or under compulsion, for God loves a cheerful giver. 2 Corinthians 9, 7. The rabbis taught, the poor man does more for the giver than the giver does for the poor man. Leviticus, Rabbah 34, 8. Why? Because, as Deuteronomy 15, 10 says, if you give generously to the poor, the Lord your God will bless you in all your work and in all your undertakings. Deuteronomy 15, 10. The person who gives to the poor man seems to be doing the poor man a favor, but he is actually receiving the gift of God's blessing from the poor man. A person who refuses to give to the poor forgets that he himself depends on the generosity of God. If we refuse to be generous when we see others in need, why should God help us when we are in need? Yeshua refers to giving to the poor as storing up treasure in heaven, Matthew 19 and 21. Money spent on charity should be regarded as an investment. A wise investor does not hesitate to put his money into a venture that will guarantee a good return. Making wise investments, how to gain an everlasting reward and treasure in heaven. A person who refuses to give to the poor forgets that he himself depends on the generosity of God. If we refuse to be generous when we see others in need, why should God help us when we are in need? Yeshua refers to giving to the poor as stirring up treasures in heaven.
I think we repeated that one. We must have needed to hear that twice. Praise God.
I just want to add to that little story mom had shared. I wanted to say that when we were standing in line at the gas station, and this lady, she didn't look poor. She had a really nice outfit on. And she had either an expensive weave or a nice wig, one of the two on. And she looked really beautiful. But when she was paying for her gas, she was counting out change. It was like $12 for the gas. And then she bought that piece of gum for a dime. This is when the Lord spoke to me and said, I want you to give to that woman. And so I had a certain amount of my wallet that I gave to her. I walked out to the pump and I asked her, I said, you know, you have to listen to the Holy Spirit. That's my point. You've got to listen to the Holy Spirit. You don't always know by the way somebody looks. A lot of times they're putting the cone on. I've seen a man standing on a corner that had been on the same corner for months. At the end of the day, go back behind the building, get in a really nice, cherried out, classic El Camino, and put on a new set of clean clothes and drive down the road and pick up his girlfriend who was standing by the freeway doing the same thing. You know, I mean, sometimes they're con artists. But you've got to listen to the Holy Spirit. This woman did not look poor at all. She looked really well put together. And then I went out to the pump and I said, do you believe in Jesus? And she said, I like to think that I do. And I said, well, he just said to give this to you. And I gave her, it was $25 is what the Lord told me to give her. And so I gave her that money. And when I came over to my pump and started pumping it down, I was just happy that I was obedient to God. I said, you know, Lord, praise the Lord. And I looked up and she was standing there in front of my car with tears in her eyes. And she says, can I hug you? And I said, yeah, give me a hug. And she gave me a hug. She said, you really do hear from God. She said, you know, I've got kids. I got to take to school. And I got to get back. You know, do anybody know? An olive branch. So they knew there was a tree that wasn't underwater, and they knew they could go out. And so they went out of the ark, and I know they teach you the rainbow means something else today, but it was really a promise from God. When they came out of the ark, there was a beautiful rainbow in the sky. And you know what God told Noah? He said, every time you see a rainbow, remember, I will never use water to destroy the earth again. So God's never going to flood the earth again, so we don't have to be afraid of that. Amen? So there's a little song. Do you kids know it? It goes, the Lord, he told Noah to build him an arky, arky. Lord, he told Noah to build him an arky, arky. Build it out of gopher barky, barky, children of the Lord. The animals, they came by twosies, twosies. Animals, they came by twosies, twosies. Elephants and kangaroosies, roosies, children of the Lord. It rained and rained for 40 daisies, daisies. Rained and rained for 40 daisies, daisies. Almost drove us. Animals, crazy, crazy children of the Lord. The sun came up and dried up the water, water. Sun, it came up and dried up the water, water. Everything was doing better, better children of the Lord. So arise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory. Rise and shine and give God the glory, glory, children of the Lord. Amen? All right, that was our children's church today. Praise God. We're going to get our room ready for you. I love the children. I had to make up words that I forgot to that song.
One of those verses I made up didn't rhyme, did it? praise the Lord. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Well, at this time, we're going to have Brother Ray come. He has a song today. And he is going to sing Life is Worth Living.
Thank you.
without any further delay, we would like to invite Elder Johnny Watts, our assistant pastor, to come now and bring forth the word of God. So welcome him with a round of applause for thanksgiving to welcome the Lord today.
Praise God, praise God. Glory to his name. I don't know whether y'all see it up on the bulletin, but the topic of it is John baptized Jesus. It's the topic of the lesson.
Amen. Mark 1:9. And it came to pass in those days that Jesus came from Nazareth of Galilee and was baptized of John in Jordan. Luke 3:21. Now when all the people were baptized, it came to pass that Jesus also being baptized and praying, the heaven was opened. Mm-hmm. And straightway coming up out of the water, he saw the heavens opened and the Spirit like a dove descending upon him. Mark 1:10. John 1:32. And John bare record, saying, I saw the Spirit descending from heaven like a dove, and abode upon him. Mark 1:11. And there came a voice from heaven, saying, Thou art my beloved Son, in whom I am well pleased.
Amen. Praise God. You know, in this day and time, we got to remember that we still have to be baptized. If Jesus was baptized by John the Baptist in the biblical days, that means we still have to be baptized in this day and time. But in order to be baptized, we got to surrender all unto God. We got to give him our all and all. That means we have to repent of all our sins in order to meet God. A lot of times we figure that we can do what we want to do and get away with it, but we can't. Simply because God is watching you just like he's watching me. And when God sees your wrongdoing, he's gonna chastise you. And the worst whooping you can get is from God. And if he came all the way from Nazareth to Galilee to be baptized by John in the river of Galilee, that means whatever and wherever the water may be, and the pastor decides he wants to do a baptism, be ready to be dipped under the water. And if Jesus was dipped under the water, that means we have to be dipped under the water also. And say, when all the peoples was baptized, and it came to pass that Jesus also being baptized and praying, said the heavens open up to let you know. If the heavens open up to let you know that Jesus Christ is God's true living Son, that means if we want to be in his hands, in his arms, we got to surrender all. We can't say that I know him and don't know about him. You can know him and not know about him. To know about him is to render all unto him. Give your all and all. And let God use you in the way he needs to use you. We can't do nothing except God be with us in the first place. Whatever we have and wherever we go, God leads and guides the way. You can cry out, I got a job, I got it on my own. No, you didn't. God provided it for you.
The clothes I got on my back, I got it on my own. No, you didn't. God provided that. Whatever you have, God surrendered it. You got a mother, you got a father, God provided that. And when we get to the point to where we're going to disobey and do like we want to do and say what we want to say to our parents, disobedience is not of God. Do you realize and do you understand every time you disobey your parents, do wrong unto them, your days is shortened? A lot of people don't believe it, but it's true. Your days is short. And that's why we gotta be ready when Jesus comes. It's a straight away up out of the water. He was. The heavens open up. And the spirit like a dove descended upon him, which means the Spirit of God. And when the Spirit of God descended upon us, that let us know that we are one of his chosen ones. And whatever God has for us, we got to receive it according to his will and his way. Because he is the one that does the baptizing. And John, receiving, saying, I saw the Spirit descend from the heavens like a dove and lit upon him. Now, if a dove, we think of the regular doves here on earth, but we're talking about a spiritual dove, which is of God. And when the spiritual dove of God descends from the heavens and light upon you, you know that God is in charge. When the pastor was speaking about the prayer of healing, I felt the anointing right then and there. That lets you know when you come into God's sanctuary, you come to give him the praise, you come to glorify him, you come to hold up the bloodstained banner. You didn't just come to sit in the seat and warm the seat. You came to glorify him, for he's worthy to be praised. He's worthy to be glorified. He's worthy to be lifted up. We come to magnify the Lord because he's worthy to be praised. Hallelujah, Jesus. And there came a voice from the heavens saying, Art my beloved son, whom I am well pleased. Now, if the Spirit of God descends from the heavens and like a dove and light upon his son's shoulders and said, this is my son who I'm well pleased with, I want to be one of those. You want to be one of those children that God says he's well pleased with. You don't want to be one of them. He said, oh, depart from me, for I know you not. For all your work was in the vindictive. I wanted to say, well done, my good and faithful servant. Enter into the kingdom of God. And when you surrender your all unto God and receive him as your savior and your keeper, your leader and your guide, then you are ready to be baptized. And when you are baptized, you come up as a new creature.
Yes.
Kills the old creature. Becomes up as a new creature in Christ. And if you can remember sometime when you was a child growing up, and I can remember the first time that I told my parents and my aunts and uncles that I had received the Lord, the first thing they ought to know, you didn't. But they don't know my heart. They don't know what God done for me. Nobody knows but God. And as time goes on, and if you're living for God, somebody sees the difference in your life. They watch the way you walk. They watch the way you talk. They watch the way you dress. They watch the way you carry yourself and your attitude also. That means we got to get ready. Because Jesus, God Almighty, is soon to come. And I want to be ready when he comes. I want to be ready when he comes. We don't know the day, nor the hour, nor the minute, nor the second that God shall return. So be ready when he comes back to receive him for yourself. Nobody can receive the Lord for you. Nobody can receive him for you. You got to receive him on your own for yourself. Your own soul salvation. Your own soul salvation. Because when judgment day come, you and you only gonna face God. Your mother can't face him, your sister, brother, your aunt, your uncle, mother, none of them can face God, but you. You gotta face him. You gotta be judged. And when God starts judging, and if the wrong outweigh the good, hellbound you are. And I want to be in heaven where there's sugar and honey. Howdy, howdy, and never goodbye. But if you're bound for hell, look out. Because down there is fire. Everlasting fire. Ask for bread, he give you a bread. Ask for water, he gonna bring you a flame of fire. So be ready. Get yourself together. Get on the right track. Surrender yourself unto the Lord. Be baptized with the Spirit of God. And live for him. Live for it. Walk for it. Say, for God I live, and for God I die. Because I want to be ready when he comes. And if you ain't ready, you better start preparing now. Because Jesus is soon to come. A lot sooner than we think it is. He's on his way back. Get ready. Get ready for the Lord. Hallelujah. Says, wait in the water, children. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the waters. And wait in the water, children. Wait in the water, children. Wait in the water. God's gonna trouble the water. See that hope all dressed in red. God's gonna trouble the water. Hope looks like the hopes that most of the dead. God's gonna trouble the water. I said, wait in the water, children. Wait in the water, children. gonna trouble the water. Leader look like the Israelites. God's gonna trouble the water. Say we in the water, children, we. In the water, children, we. In the water. God's gonna trouble the water. I said God's gonna trouble the water. If you don't believe I've been redeemed, God's gonna trouble the water. Follow me down to the turning stream. God's gonna trouble the water. Say we in the water, children, we. In the water, children, we. In the water, God's gonna trouble the water. I said God's gonna trouble the water. Say God's gonna trouble. He's gonna trouble the water. The water. If you need your body healed and your soul saved, step in the water.